Dear students, I am Dr. Rajiv Sapre and this is 33rd audio for you. In this audio also, I will continue the discussion about locus. In the last audio, we have seen what is meant by shift of origin and what are the formulae which relate old coordinates small x small y, new coordinates capital X capital Y, and the point where origin is shifted h comma k. You know that the formula is small x is equal to capital X plus h, small y is equal to capital Y plus k, or in other words, capital X is equal to small x minus h, capital Y is equal to small y minus k. Here small x small y are old coordinates and capital X capital Y are new coordinates. This is always there, we have to remember that. Now suppose you are asked, if the origin is shifted to the point minus 2 comma 1, right? Origin is shifted to the point minus 2 comma 1, the axis remaining parallel, find old coordinates of the point say 2 comma 4. Now what I will do? Old coordinates are 2 comma 4, so small x and small y are 2 and 4. Right, origin is shifted to minus 2 comma 1, so h will be minus 2, k will be 1. I want to find new coordinates, right? I am asked to find new coordinates. So what I will do? Old coordinates are 2 comma 4, so small x small y is 2 and 4, and h comma k where the origin is shifted to minus 2 comma 1. I want to find new coordinates. So what is the formula for new coordinates? Capital X is equal to small x minus h. So what will be here? Small x minus h, 2 minus minus 2, so it will become 4, and capital Y is small y minus k. Capital Y is small y minus k. Is it right? So what will be that? 4 minus 1, so it will be 3. So this is very simple, nothing difficult in this. See, you have to properly read the problem. And now, not only here, everywhere, whenever you are solving any mathematical problem, first you should read the problem properly. While reading the problem, in your mind there should be some thinking, how to solve, which method I will use, what are the given things, what I want to prove that actually what I have to do, or what, which formulae I will use to prove the results that are asked. So all this process must be there in your mind whenever you are reading any problem, solving any problem. Your involvement in solving mathematical problems is very, very important. Not only in mathematics, whenever you are studying, your involvement in that study counts. If you are not involved in the study, it's of no use. Temporarily, you may get some good marks. But concrete study, concretely, you should remember the ideas, you should remember the formulae, you should remember the methods, you should practice. Practice is the only way to get the success. Without practicing, mathematics cannot be done. If you solve 3 and 4 problems on a particular topic, then you will not be able to understand the insight of that topic. But if you solve 300, 400 problems related with that topic, then definitely your ideas will be more clear. I am not saying it will be totally clear, but ideas will be more clear if you solve many problems like this. Now, actually where the concept of shift of origin is used, that we will see. Definitely you have to sit with pen and paper to understand this problem. I will go slowly. But try to understand what is actually happening. See, if the origin is shifted to the point, if the origin is shifted to the point 2 comma minus 1, obtain the new equation of the locus 2x square plus 3xy minus 9y square minus 5x minus 24y minus 7 is 0. Axis remaining parallel. So, see, you are given an equation and they are asking you to find new equation. That immediately tells you that this is old equation. So, okay, this is old equation. And now you are going to find the new equation and you are told that origin is shifted to 2, minus 1. So now you have xy, small x and small y, which tells you that this is the old equation. And now when I shift origin to 2, minus 1, so h and k will be 2 and minus 1. Now how to relate? Suppose I take that capital X and capital Y, okay, are the new coordinates. What is the relation between all these three things? Small x is equal to capital X plus H and small y is equal to capital Y plus K. And here H and K are 2 and minus 1. So what will be small x? Capital X plus 2 and small y will be capital Y minus 1. So whatever equation is given to you, in that equation you put small x as capital X plus 2 and small y as capital Y minus 1. Understood? Very simple. Nothing difficult in this. And now you have to make the calculation. So what is the equation? 2x square. So you will write 2 into bracket x plus 2 bracket square plus 3xy. That was old equation is 2x square plus 3xy minus 9y square minus 5x minus 24y minus 7 is 0. Now in this equation you are going to put small x as capital X plus 2 and small y as capital Y minus 1. And so what you get is 2 into x plus 2 bracket square plus 3 into x plus 2 into y minus 1 minus 9 into y minus 1 square minus 5 into x plus 2 minus 24 into y minus 1 minus 7 is 0. Now you have to simplify all that. X plus 2, capital X plus 2 bracket square is what? X square plus 4x plus 4. Then you will multiply that by 2. Okay. Similarly, 3 into capital X plus 2 into capital Y minus 1. So you have to make that product, capital X plus 2 into capital Y minus 1. So it will be capital X capital Y minus X plus 2Y minus 2. Everything is capital here. Then third term was minus 9 into capital Y minus 1 bracket square. I will not say capital now. It is assumed that it is capital now. So it will be y squared minus 2y plus 1 inside the bracket. And bracket is to be multiplied by minus 9. And so on. When you make the calculations, finally you will and simplify. Finally you will reach to the answer 2x square plus 3xy minus 9y square. 2 into capital X square plus 3 into capital X capital Y minus 9 into capital Y square. Right? So this is the new equation of the locus. So always it is asked, some equation is given, right? And you are also told where origin is shifted. And you are asked to find the new equation of that particular locus. So this is very important, because when you, in many cases, the equation of the locus that is given to you, old equation, may be confusing. Immediately by seeing, suppose I am given equation x square plus y square is equal to 16, I can immediately tell this is equation of circle. If it is of the form x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is 1, I can say easily that this is equation of ellipse. But apparently, equation of the locus you can understand whenever it has a standard form. But when the given equation is not in standard form, then possibly shift of origin will make our ideas clear and we can understand what is the nature of that locus. For that, this idea of shift of origin is very useful. Remember, Shift of origin is very useful. This idea makes the things more simple. So one more problem I will discuss, not necessarily of the shift of origin, but these problems that I am discussing, you should, as I told, you should sit with pen and pencil and work on that. So next problem that I am going to discuss is this. That is, suppose O is the origin and O is a variable point on the locus x square is equal to 4y. Find the equation of locus of the midpoint of segment OQ. O is the origin and Q is the variable point. What is the meaning of this? Q changes its positions. Q changes its positions. Q is a variable point on which locus x square is equal to 4y. So Q x square is equal to 4y is a locus. So it is a set of points. Infinitely many points are there which satisfy that equation x square is equal to 4y. So when you are told that Q is the variable point on that locus, that means Q takes, see, you will study afterwards that x square is equal to 4y is an equation of parabola. Equation of parabola. So you take parabola is not just one point, it is set of points. So Q can be any of those points. Origin is fixed, but then OQ will be different in every case because Q is variable. Q is changing its position, but it is changing its position by being on that particular curve, x square is equal to 4y. Are you getting this? Q is a variable point on that locus. Which is that locus? X square is equal to 4y. So it is a parabola, and we are told that Q is the variable point on that parabola. So Q will change its position, O will be fixed. So each time, whatever is the segment OQ, it will have different lengths. Because O is fixed is okay, but Q is changing. And so each time the segment OQ will have different form. And I am asked to find the locus of midpoints of the segment OQ. Okay, so now what I have to do? Say Q you can take as A comma B. Q is A comma B, suppose, and it is the point on the locus whose equation is x square is equal to 4y. So by putting A comma B in the equation of locus x square is equal to 4y, it means I will put x is equal to A, y is equal to B. So I get A square is equal to 4b. Right, this is the first equation. Now let P x comma y be the required point on the locus. What is told? P is midpoint of OQ, where O is origin. Q I have taken A comma B. So I am calculating midpoint of O and Q, where O is origin and Q is A comma B, and that midpoint is P x comma y. So by applying midpoint formula, I am going to get coordinates of P. I have taken coordinates of P as x comma y. So x is equal to what? 0 plus a upon 2. You know midpoint formula. Use it. X will be 0 plus a upon 2 and y will be 0 plus b upon 2. What is midpoint formula? If x1, y1 is one point, x2, y2 is another point, then their midpoint is x1 plus x2 upon 2, comma y1 plus y2 upon 2. So here x1, y1 is 0, 0 and x2, y2 is a, b. Whenever I apply that formula, I get x is equal to a upon 2 and y is equal to b upon 2. So I will get a is equal to 2x, b is equal to 2y. Okay. Now this thing you can put in that formula. What is that formula? A square is equal to 4b. In that you will put this. When you put it, I get 4x square, because what is the equation that we are, in which I am putting the values of a and b? A square is equal to 4b. Okay, so a is 2x, so 2x square, that is 4x square, and 2b, so it is, sorry, 4b, so it is 4 into 2y. Right, so finally I get 4x square is equal to 8y. And you can cancel 4 throughout, and I will get x square is equal to 2y. So this is the required equation of the locus.
right? So this type of many problems now I have discussed in all the previous videos also and in this video also. I hope you understand these formulae. This completes the discussion on the locus. I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.